Hi everybody, this is Byron Jacobs for everymanchess.com making a short video about a new book, The Triangle System by Grandmaster Ruslan Scherbakov. This book will be available in the UK and Europe in February 2012 and in the United States in April 2012. The author, Ruslan Scherbakov, has a fine pedigree as he's a strong grandmaster and former Russian junior champion. He's also very well known as a trainer with more than 20 years' experience and also very renowned as a strong opening theoretician, so you can be sure that the information in this book will all be an absolutely top-notch analysis. The content of this book, The Triangle System, breaks down into three sections. There's a section on the Noteboom Variation, a section on the Marshall Gambit, and a section on other Semi-Slav Triangle lines. I flicked over here onto the contents page and you can see that first of all we have the Noteboom Variation, which is part one of the book, which breaks up into various different systems, and then this follows on with part two being the Marshall Gambit, and then part three covering what has been described as anti-triangle systems. Now, just so that you know exactly the opening systems that are being discussed in this book, I'm going to play through the variations in their broad form so that you get a clear idea of exactly what's on offer here. Black's idea is that he will set up in the opening this so-called triangle formation by playing the pawns to e6, c6 and d5. Obviously it's possible to alternate the move that's played on move 2, but essentially after three moves he will set up this triangle system in the centre, and white has various ways to try and prove an advantage against this black structure, and these tries form the topic of this book. First of all, white can try what's known as the Noteboom Variation by playing 4 knight f3. Now black, a big move here for black is knight f6, which leads to another complex of lines entirely, but black can capture on c4, after which a typical variation runs as follows: a4, bishop b4, e3, b5, bishop d2, a5. This leads to very dynamic, unbalanced play, and is the subject, these variations are the subject of much of the first part of this book. As you can see, white has gambited a pawn, but what typically happens is that white will actually regain this pawn, but black will end up with two connected passed pawns on the queen side, whereas white will have a preponderance of pawns in the centre. And as I mentioned, this leads to very dynamic double-edged play with chances for both sides, and this line is explored in some detail in the book. The second approach that white can take, if we go back to move 3, is rather than bringing his knight out to f3, is to play 4e4. This line is well known and goes under the name of the Marshall Gambit. Play typically continues d takes e4, knight takes bishop check, bishop d2, queen takes d4. Obviously this is the reason it's a gambit, because black has grabbed the central d pawn. White now takes the bishop and black takes the knight with check. White's main move here is bishop e2, after which the play again becomes very complicated. White has sacrificed an important central pawn, but has the bishop pair, and obviously black's development lags a little. And this variation and similar lines form the topic of the second part of the book. The third part of the book deals with some quieter white attempts. So, for example, if we return to our basic triangle structure, white might play the more passive move e3, not directly challenging black. And in the book, Ruslan suggests that black can respond to this with f5, which leads to this typical Stonewall Dutch structure, where white has adopted a formation which isn't as immediately threatening as some of his more dynamic lines against this black opening. A couple of other things white can try: he can play knight f3 instead of knight c3 on move 3. Again, black goes c6 and now takes the opportunity to meet some quiet variations, for example queen c2 with an active development of the bishop, or if instead of queen c2, knight bd2, again He recommends the move f5 to try and gain a Stonewall Dutch where white doesn't have such a threatening setup. So that's the basic idea of the book. It acts as a repertoire for black with the opening moves of d5, e6 and c6, gives detailed analysis of all possible white attempts to gain a serious advantage against this, and also covers some of the sidelines involving quieter white development. So it acts as a complete repertoire for black against the move 1d4, and is also obviously of use to white players who play 1d4 and might wonder how to counter this system. It's a big book, coming in at 448 pages. There's a lot of detailed analysis. It's not based around complete games, but takes the structure of a theoretical framework. As already mentioned, it will be available in the UK, Europe in February of 2012, and in the United States in April of 2012. You can get the book from any normal chess book stockist, or obviously you can also order online from amazon.com or amazon.co.uk, and you can download some more information from the everymanchess.com website. Thanks for listening. This has been Byron Jacobs for Everyman Chess.